Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Best of Slot, and we are back playing Her Story, the murder investigation game. And in the last episode, I've got my trusty pen and I've got my trusty paper. In the last episode, we just started to do a little research into the miscarriage that this woman had. Now, if I refer to my notes, which is very exciting for me, they were going to have a baby girl, her husband, her supposed husband, what was his name again? Simon Smith. Wanted the girl to be called Ava. She preferred Sarah because she didn't want it to be a palindrome like her name, Hannah. Or is her name Hannah? We don't think that's her real name. So we're going to do some research into this miscarriage, and then we're going to go check out this whole naming business. Play.
Then my parents died.
Oh, lovely.
It was the worst year of my life. The miscarriage and then my parents.
That's a pretty bad year, it must be said. That's a pretty rough year. We're going to have a look at this. Apparently this is in order, somewhat. So I can tell I'm missing like one volume at the start, which would appear to be this one up here. Now, there's no way to check them. I wish I could click these videos and actually load up those videos, but I suppose that would defeat the point of it. The point is, if this is meant to be in order, maybe, then I've got like, I don't have the last one, but I do have the first one. I don't really know how that works, but either way, that shows you how many videos there are still left in the game, which is pretty helpful.
Yeah. They'd gone to bed feeling ill, thinking it was flu or something. The neighbour called me, I had to use my key to let them in. We found them dead in their bed. And they'd been there for days, no one had noticed. Just awful.
But what killed them?
It was so soon after my miscarriage. In the worst year of my life. I'd been so happy to get married, and after that it was just like, fuck.
But what killed them?
Yeah. I was infertile. Thought I was. They told me I was infertile after the miscarriage because of complications.
Isn't she pregnant now? Didn't we figure that out? Okay.
I got pregnant. Both our parents had a big powwow. We weren't even in the room. And they decided we should get married.
Okay, so kind of a forced marriage then. God, there's a lot of... Oh, I think we're getting a bit ahead here. Oh well.
They said it was food poisoning. There was something in the food they ate. My dad liked to pick mushrooms, grow them too. They said it was the mushrooms. It was hard to believe. Death caps. They have a skirt around the cap. My dad taught me that. But, I mean, the police had no reason to think it was suspicious. They lived alone. And no one had any reason to hurt them.
Except the mushrooms. If you've been picking mushrooms your whole life, they're going to fight back eventually. Ooh, my face.
I was living in the attic. It was a very hard time. I was depressed. I was still pretty sick of the STD. And I came down one morning and they were dead. They were in bed and both had been sick. They'd thrown up a lot. And I'd slept through it. The police said it was the mushrooms they ate. Dad was a mushroom expert. I mean, he used to take us picking with him and he taught us how to recognize them. There's no way you would have picked death caps. But the police believe that's what happened. They never even looked in the attic.
What's in the attic? Right. Oh God. You can see that was about, if I'm right, yeah, that was about a month. Not even a month, that was Okay, that was like 3 days.
They said it was food poisoning.
Only a few days after that first one, but you can already see like the differences in times where she starts getting more and more ragged. This one is earlier, and this is...
It's the Rockington Arms.
She's calmer, and she's better dressed, and it kind of... She gets worse and worse as it goes by. Okay, we've got a few things to look for here. Let's go for STD, which randomly just came up. What's the STD about?
The parents decided there would be a wedding. And after the wedding, Hannah moved in with his parents. There was no way I could follow. So we were separated.
What?
I stayed in the attic. It was hard. It's like I suddenly didn't exist. I would sneak out, but in case anyone recognised me, I started wearing a wig. Hannah and I would meet up in the park. I was trying to get pregnant. But I couldn't. I mean, I couldn't do it with anyone we knew, so it was sex with strangers, drunk guys I'd met in clubs, parks and alleyways. I was 17. It felt like I was being punished. But it was Hannah who had betrayed us. I had to stop when one of the guys gave me an STD. When we met up, it was disturbing. For the first time, my reflection, she didn't look like me. She was fatter, flushed. If anything, I was getting skinnier. I don't hardly look sometimes. We talked about what to do. Was it time to become our own people? I mean, that seemed like the right thing to do, but neither of us wanted it. We agreed that her and Simon would get their own place as soon as possible, and then I could move in. And that was the plan.
So do we reckon she's schizophrenic? Like, this Hannah... She said she was Hannah at the start, right? And now she's obviously saying she's not Hannah. And she's been meeting with Hannah, but then she lived with Hannah in the same building. Like, how were they gonna... And she lived in the attic of the parents. How was she ever gonna pull that off? Did I search for attic? Okay, we got a few of these. But then we're gonna search for real name, because we need to really dig into that.
Yes. I read a lot as a child, and watched lots of TV. Then the doll's house we had, we still have in the attic. It's kind of a fairy castle. We used to play up there and make up our own stories.
I'm going to start... I'm making a little timeline, right, of what she's wearing. It's just because I'm so into fashion, you know. No, a little timeline of the clothes she's wearing in chronological order. So...
Yes.
25th. So that we can kind of... use the date and what she's doing at that time as kind of a judge of attitude or how the story fits together a little bit better. So it's then WBB. I think there's five. I think. Although there's one where she's got a guitar. We did see the guitar, but we've never heard it. So maybe we'll do search for guitar in a minute. So at the moment, I've got blue jacket, that the fancy one, into the blue shirt. Not this one. That one on the left, then it's the orange jacket, then it's the white and blue shirt, and then it's the white shirt.
Could the hairs have come from somewhere else?
Hairs.
Could they... We have a lot of dolls in the attic. There's a Rapunzel doll with long blonde hair. Could they have come from there?
Long blonde hair? Wonder what colour hair Hannah has, because you're not Hannah-ish, sort of.
She recognised me from the window. She told me to come inside, and she hid me. They had made the attic into a place where Hannah could play. There was a dollhouse. She hid me up there. No one else ever went into the attic. It was her place.
This is so weird. It really is.
I'm not sure where the dollhouse came from. But don't know if it was given to them or they inherited it, and they wouldn't have had the money to buy it, was so huge. It must have been taken up to the attic in parts and then reassembled up there. It's a beautiful thing. Wallpaper to scale, little furniture, the lights work, mirrors, beds, big duvets and pillows. We spent hours and hours playing in it, invented all these characters and families who lived there. We wrote paperwork for them all, passports, diaries, gave them all really elaborate stories. Once, a moth got trapped in there. We'd left a light on. It was making the most horrendous noise. We tried to kill it, but it was tough. We ended up crushing it under a copy of the Arabian Nights.
Remind me never to go live in her dollhouse. Moth. The moth is important. The moth's not important. Okay, that was optimistic. Right, no. Ignore. I've got a list of other keywords to search for, but let's just focus on real name. Okay, my name. Give me something here.
He saw me singing. One of my shows. Pure chance. Not sure I remember what he was even doing there. Afterwards, I had a drink at the bar and he came over and we got talking. I knew who he was. Obviously, I knew who he was. But he didn't know who I was. He was fascinated by the likeness. He guessed my name from my tattoo. Told me it was a palindrome, but that would impress me. I enjoyed talking to him. It was amazing to be able to sit and interact and talk to him after all this time. He didn't tell me he was married. I'm not sure what he was thinking. He later told me it was like he was dreaming. A waking dream.
This just gets weirder and weirder. I'm struggling, like, before this episode, I had a pretty clear image in my head of what was going on, and it has fallen down a little bit. So, based on just what she's told us, she goes to a bar, she meets Simon, she's singing, she obviously knows who he is for some reason, so she's been watching him, following him or something for a long time. He doesn't know who she is. He's married to Hannah, right? I think she's schizophrenic because she's presenting two different sides of Hannah. But which one we're seeing is maybe dependent on the date and the clothes she's wearing. So that's why we're keeping... How do you spell tattoo? Am I spelling tattoo wrong? That's not how you spell tattoo, is it? She says she's got a name as a tattoo. So I'm hoping it doesn't say Hannah. I'm hoping it's another palindrome that's not Hannah.
No, he doesn't have any tattoos.
But do you...
He has a scar down here near his stomach, past his hip. Cut himself with some glass. That was before, a long time ago. He looks just like the photo. He's not got his glasses on here though. He takes them off for the camera. But he needs them to see properly, you know. He has to read a newspaper or a menu in a restaurant. Not books so much, or watching TV.
Married? I'd apologise for a siren, but it kind of works for this game. Why would he not need them for books, but if he needed them... Oh, somebody told me to do something. Like, there's something in here. There's a hint somewhere. Is it in the bin? What's that say? Crow... Something hack. G-hack, mirror game. I don't think this is relevant. Cracks with glass. Oh, class. I thought that was like a really subtle hint there. That's just a game. For the freedom of information. any hints? I'll see anything. More tattoos! Show me yours.
Oh, my tattoo. I got it to express my individuality. It's an apple and a snake.
Why? Why?
So I moved out. Got a small bed set. Got my tattoo to mark the occasion. I was singing in a bar in the evenings, so I had some money, enough money to cover my rent. And I've been doing something similar ever since. I haven't put down any roots. I don't exist.
I'm definitely getting that impression.
Then she told me she wanted to help more. She said I should move in with her. She would come clean with Simon about me. I was family. I couldn't have a baby in a bedsit. I told her I didn't want to tell Simon. Told her to wait for the time being.
Okay, hairs. What's all this about the blonde hairs and the dot? Ah, see, there's more guitar. So this, that's actually all in order. Cool. Like, ah,
it's Rapunzel.
Look at that.
The story starts when she's born. Mother Gothel, a witch, takes Rapunzel from her parents and keeps her locked up in this tower. Rapunzel gets pregnant by the prince, and Mother Gothel is furious, so she cuts off her hair and throws it. Actually, her hair's already short here, so that's already happened. So she throws him into the wilderness, and Rapunzel is reunited with the prince, who's blind. But she kills him with her tears, and so it's a happy ending. Is that too much?
It's like the Pokemon movie.
What kind of hairs?
That's what I'm curious about. What kind of hairs? And then she says this afterwards.
Could the hairs have come from somewhere else?
So they found some blonde hair. Has she been dyeing her hair? Oh, I don't have this in the list.
You want me to play something? I'm not the world's best guitar player. Okay. Probably needs tuning.
Yeah.
good place to stop.
Gets really weird. Gets? You just... How is that a ballad? I just find it a little too on the nose that there's this guy that they both like and the sister happens to be blonde, so let's go ahead and search for sister.
When she went home, Simon had a birthday tea waiting. Afterwards, she told Simon about me, told him I was pregnant. She wanted me to move in with them, this sister he didn't know she had. She knew that instant. The look on his face.
She knew. Okay, so let's assume for a moment that she's not schizophrenic and that she was just pretending to be Hannah at the start because her sister's and therefore look alike and maybe she thought she could get out of something or something like that. Let's just pretend for now she's not. That's the situation. In that case, she meets Simon, who's already married, to her sister. They hook up, obviously. Shut up, world. She, who we're now going to call Blobby, because why not? Blobby gets pregnant from Simon, assumedly. So she's having this baby, and her sister, Hannah, sees this and is like, oh no, you must come live with us. So she goes to move in with them and introduces her to Simon, and Simon sees her, and obviously, Hannah in this situation sees that Simon and Blobby obviously have a history, and then she clicks that, oh, the baby is Simon's, right? Now, what is living in the attic go into that? Because she lived in the attic of the parents' house, or so she says.
My sister is gone, and she's never coming back.
Well, that's not creepy. Right. What do we get when we search for Hannah? Oh, okay. How did I never do that? Was that Morse code? Okay, we're gonna search for Eve in a second. Eve is one of the kids. Eve, I think... I remember hearing about Eve and I haven't quite got good enough notes. It's just under the headline, Baby, along with a few other names.
Across the road, where my parents first lived there, was a midwife called Florence. When Hannah was born, I was born at the same time. The midwife was there to help. I'd been throttled by the cord, probably wrapped around my neck by Hannah. The midwife told my mother I was dead. But I wasn't.
Clearly.
She wrote all this stuff in a diary. Amazing what people will admit to on paper.
There's my face. Okay, let's search for Eve. I need clarification.
Well, my friend Eve. I mean, she was a friend from when I was a kid. And she was always more popular with the boys. And I used to hate her for it. I mean, really hate her sometimes.
You killed her! I thought Eve was a baby. Why have I got Eve under the headline baby?
Yes. We'd fight. We fought on the beach once, and I held Eve's head underwater. There was no one else around. It was at the far end of the beach. And I held her head under and I kept it out. And for a moment, I just wanted to kill her and watch her drown. But that was it. It was just a moment. We made up afterwards. It was a love-hate relationship.
Not getting the love in that, let's be honest.
My mother called me Eve.
What? What are you doing to me? Game! Ah! Right. What? I mean, what?
Simon didn't play guitar. He wasn't very musical. He liked to listen, but he was tone deaf.
I just... What? Right, so she's just inventing this story about drowning Eve at the beach? But then she went and sang the song. I reckon she did... No. I don't know.
Yes. Yeah, it's my guitar.
That wasn't very helpful.
Really?
Yes, please. You crazy son of a gun. That's right. Clap for the crazy woman. Okay, let's check this database checker. We've kind of... I feel like there's this section in the middle that I'm just missing out on entirely. Because we're getting these a couple of these quite ending ones, you know? It'd be nice... What's that there? What's the one volume missing DB3? Can I actually just search for DB3? Let's have a look. DB3. This is optimistic. Yeah, that was optimistic. Okay. But... What am I missing? You know, that's... It's the basic, because at this moment I don't actually have much in the way of keywords. We've gone through most of the ideas I had. I'm at a slight dead end. I'm gonna have a think about it before the next episode. But this is, it's gone past a simple murder investigation. That's not what it's about anymore. It's about who is this woman, you know? What's going on? Like, how. Like, is she Eve? Is she Hannah? Is she some... Like, her mother called her Hannah. That's what she said. Her mother called her Eve. That's what she said. In the earlier videos, she referred to herself in Hannah. In the later videos, she refers to the woman who's with Simon and that she went to live with as Hannah. So is she Eve and she's Hannah? But then she refers to her friend as Eve. So... Real name isn't a thing, is it? No. No, okay. I need to be more specific and get into these late. Eve Blonde. No, okay. Well, we're going to end it there. Thank you very much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. I absolutely adore this game. I still adore this game. It is so interesting and so confusing and so mind-blowing at times. This episode has been a little bit crazy. Hope those of you who are sticking around are enjoying the series as much as I do, and I shall see you lovely people in the next episode. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye.